हेलो गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल माय डियर फ्रेंड्स सो वेलकम बैक द वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज वी आर डिस्कसिंग द असिमेट्रिक सिंथेसिस टॉपिक इन लास्ट वीडियो वी हैव कवर्ड द डायस्टीरियोसिलेक्टिविटी इन असिमेट्रिक अल्डोल रिएक्शंस ओके सो द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्टरी पार्ट ऑफ दैट असिमेट्रिक अल्डोल रिएक्शन we discussed yesterday okay now today we are going to see the next model which explains the diastereoselectivity is nothing but Pelkin-Ahn model there are number of theories put forth by the different group of scientists and some of these theories are explaining excellently the diastereoselectivity or the stereochemistry of the product formed by the asymmetric aldol reaction out of these the first one is Pelkin-Ahn model and then next one is Cramp's rule etc now this Pelkin-Ahn model is depends or it is basically related to the angle of nucleophilic attack of the nucleophile to the electrophilic carbonyl carbon in the carbonyl compounds so we know that aldehydes and ketones forms a major group of organic compounds known as carbonyl compounds and these organic carbonyl compounds have a electrophilic center that is carbonyl carbon C double bond O and when the alpha carbon atom of this carbonyl group is having chiral center is asymmetric in nature then must be the resulting product must be diastereoselective okay so we are getting product in such a way that the resulting products from such a chiral aldehyde are we are getting diastereoselective product and so that's why if we get a racemic mixture of these diastereomers then there is no any means at all so that's why we should assign the stereochemistry of the product in favor of the starting material in such a way that we are getting enantiomeric excess or diastereomeric excess of one of the product okay so before going to in detail the Pelkin-Ahn model let us first of all see the conformations of chiral aldehyde once you got this point once this concept is clear to you then you can understand the Pelkin-Ahn model okay so I have written here one chiral aldehyde the structure of chiral aldehyde so it is CHO CH methyl and phenyl group the name of this aldehyde is 2 phenyl 1 2 3 so 2 phenyl propionyl aldehyde three carbon atoms are in the longest continuous chain so 2 phenyl propionyl aldehyde is the our desired chiral aldehyde so this is the alpha carbon atom of this aldehyde and this alpha carbon atom is chiral in nature so this is phenyl group one is there then methyl group is there and one another substituent is hydrogen atom okay now when you look this molecule in a Newman projection formula then these are the two situations where the alpha carbon atom substituents attached to the alpha carbon atom to this carbonyl group can be arranged in such a way that we have to find from which side the incoming nucleophile can attack this is the most important the incoming nucleophile in nucleophilic addition reaction or in let us say when nucleophile is attacking on the electrophilic carbonyl carbon from which angle or from which side that nucleophile is approaching towards the carbonyl carbon this is the main basic concept in Pelkin-Ahn model okay so that's why we have to find out the stable conformation of this chiral aldehyde okay so for this for getting this clear idea I have written both of these conformations and from that we have to determine which conformation is stable and which conformation is relatively unstable okay so this is the Newman projection formula okay so I have written this is the front carbon atom We know that in last year we have seen all these concepts about how to write Newman, Sauhorst and Fischer, okay, and wedge and dash formula. So this is the front carbon atom, let us say. So this front carbon atom is shown by only dot, and this is carbonyl group, C double bond O. So this dot is nothing but carbonyl carbon. Carbon oxygen double bond is there, and to this carbon oxygen double bond hydrogen is there. So this is front carbon atom, and we know that carbonyl group is sp2 hybridized. Carbonyl carbon is sp2 hybridized, and its geometry is trigonal planar. So planarity is there. So C double bond O, okay, and the hydrogen atom is written in opposite to that of this carbonyl group. Okay, so this is front carbon atom. Then next, second carbon atom is alpha carbon atom, and this alpha carbon atom is a chiral center. Okay, so this alpha carbon atom is shown by a circle, and the bonds attached, substituents attached to this alpha carbon atom, rear carbon atom, are shown by bonds starting from the outer periphery of that circle. Okay, so these are the I am writing one conformation first. So which are the substituents? Phenyl group, methyl group and hydrogen atom. So this is the one of the way that phenyl group is present, like this phenyl group, then this is methyl group, okay, which is above the plane, okay, methyl group, and the third one is hydrogen. Okay, so I have written here like this. Okay, so we have to arrange them in such a way that we should get staggered conformation, because we know that in staggered conformation energetic requirement is very less and hence stability is more. So that's why this is we are writing in staggered conformation, and from this staggered conformation we are trying to recognize that whether eclipsing interactions are there or not. Eclipsing interactions means, are there any crowding is there between the nearest atoms or groups or not. Okay, so this, or this another conformation. Okay, so I am keeping the front carbon atom, carbonyl carbon atom, as it is, and rotating the, so this is a carbon carbon single bond, carbonyl carbon, and this alpha carbon atom are carbon carbon single bond, so we can rotate it. So I am rotating this rear carbon atom, okay, like this. So thumb is my phenyl group, like this thumb is my phenyl group, my first finger is hydrogen, and this middle finger is one methyl group. So I am rotating this like this. So what is happen? So hydrogen will go here, phenyl group thumb will come here, and methyl group, that is middle finger, will go towards the right hand side. Okay, so this will be the situation. So these two are the same, one and the same. Okay, now what is this? See here, the front carbon atom, that is carbonyl carbon atom, has a this aldehydic proton. This proton and this phenyl group are near to each other. They are near to each other. Same is the case here. This phenyl group and this hydrogen atom are near to each other. Okay, so that's why when they are near to each other, so eclipsing interactions are present in this case. Eclipsing interactions are present, and hence due to this eclipsing interactions or steric crowding, let us say, because phenyl group is larger in size, these are unstable conformations. These are unstable conformations of this chiral aldehyde. Now consider the second case. Now in this case, I am again putting the front carbon atom as it is. So this front carbon atom by dot, carbonyl group, C double bond O, hydrogen, okay, opposite to that of carbonyl. Now I am putting the rear substituents of rear carbon atom in such a way that there should be minimum repulsion or minimum steric interaction should be taken place between the adjacent atoms and groups. Okay, now here what I have taken here, this phenyl group I have written in opposite. So opposite means perpendicular to this carbonyl group. So this is a carbonyl group, C double bond O, and this phenyl group I have written here, the perpendicular to this. So this is carbonyl, let us say this is carbonyl, C double bond O, okay, and I put it this alpha substituents on alpha carbon atom, that is phenyl group, like this. So it is perpendicular to each other. Okay, so like this, this is carbonyl, let us say this phenyl group is like this. Okay, and the remaining substituents are written accordingly. So hydrogen here and methyl here. Now why it is so? Remember, staggered conformation, not eclipsing. Okay, so eclipsing, or if all the groups are eclipsing, then there should be a very unstable structure. So that is not favorable. So this is staggered and favorable. Why it is favorable? Because here the hydrogen atom and phenyl group, the phenyl group and oxygen atoms are away from each other. They are away from each other. Okay. Now this is the structure are same. Only I have written this phenyl group on this side, left hand side, and accordingly the remaining groups are rotated across the carbon-carbon single bond. Okay. So these are the two same structures. Okay. Now what is this case in this phenyl group, which is a larger group in this alpha, on this alpha carbon atom, are perpendicular to this carbonyl group. Okay, and that's why this is the stable conformation. This is the stable conformation in this chiral aldehyde molecule. Okay, so arrange for the study of this Felkinen model, arrange the given carbonyl compound, whether it is aldehyde or ketone, in such a way that the larger group, in this case phenyl group, the larger group must be drawn perpendicular to the carbonyl carbon or carbonyl group. Okay, so to avoid steric interactions or eclipsing interactions and to getting maximum stability, less energy. Okay, then we can apply Felkinen model. Okay, so this is the summary of all that were discussed in this case. Okay, now in general we can write this our discussion in such a way that, so this is carbonyl group R. This R may be hydrogen atom. If it is R is equal to hydrogen, then it is aldehyde. If R is equal to alkyl or aryl group, then it is ketone. Okay, then this is alpha carbon atom, and this alpha carbon atom have larger group. Medium group and small group. Okay, so this alpha carbon atom is asymmetric. It is having chiral center. Okay, all the substances must be different. Okay, so if this is the case, then we can arrange this chiral aldehyde or ketone, that is carbon compound, like that. Central carbonyl group having R. Okay, then larger group, arrange this larger group perpendicular to this carbonyl group. So I can write here, so if larger group is written like this, so medium group, L for larger, M for medium group, medium means size of the group, and S for small size group. So medium group is, so it is above the plane, so I have written here M, and smaller group is written like this. Okay, so this is a staggered conformation in which we are getting stable conformation of given carbonyl compound. Okay, or you can write like this R group. Okay, and I am writing this larger group on the left hand side now. Okay, so methyl group will be here and hydrogen will be here, opposite direction, L here, methyl here, and hydrogen there. Okay, so these are the two these are the two stable conformations that can be obtained for by applying a general conformation rule to any chiral carbonyl compound, whether aldehyde or ketone. Okay, so these things you should keep in mind. Now apply our Felkinen model. Now this Felkinen model can apply in different ways. So according to the situation given in the substrate molecule, that is aldehyde or ketone, chiral aldehyde or ketone molecule, okay, whether they are having a metal ligand adjacent, okay, or whether they having electronegative atoms or not. So accordingly there are three basic rules can be applied, or we can say that we can apply this Felkinen model in three different ways. So today we are going to see the first basic idea of this Felkinen model. Okay, Felkinen model general, we can say I am writing it in a general means if there is no electro negative atom in this substrate except carbonyl group, or if there is no any metal or ligand group or atom attached to this substrate. Okay, so this is general. Now I am writing example. Okay, so same example here, medium. Okay, so this is carbonyl group, this is R, alpha carbon atom, and this is chiral center denoted by asterisk mark. Now what is the case? Felkinen model, we have to reduce this molecule. This is aldehyde or ketone. We have to reduce this LiAlH4. Now what is the structure of LiAlH4? Central aluminium is there, aluminium atom is there, and to this four hydride hydrogen atoms are attached to this central aluminium. So they are hydrides, are H minus. Okay, so they are hydride ions. LiAlH4 is a hydride reducing agent. Okay, so it is giving H minus, not H plus. Okay, because electronegativity of hydrogen is more than that of aluminium, so that's why H is negatively charged here and aluminium is positively charged. Okay, so this LiAlH4 minus, and the counter ion is Li plus. Okay, so this is the structure. Now what is the nucleophile here? Here in LiAlH4 or NaBH4, these are the reducing agents, and they are having H minus as the nucleophile. Okay, so when nucleophilic attack takes place on this carbonyl group, then what will be the situation? The situation will be like this. We are trying to predict the possibilities for this nucleophilic attack on this carbonyl group. Okay, so there are two possibilities. I am writing here the first possibility. Let us say I am drawing a given carbon compound in Newman projection, oxygen. This is R group. Okay, larger group perpendicular, then medium group here, and medium group here, and smaller group here. Okay, so as larger group, this alkyl group and this carbonyl oxygen are away from each other, so this is stable conformation. Now in this case, the nucleophile, incoming nucleophile, is attacking on this carbonyl carbon in an angle. It is known as Burgi-Dunitz angle. Mind well, remember well, Burgi-Dunitz angle, and it is equal to 107 degree. So the angle between carbonyl carbon is the electrophilic center, and our nucleophile is attacking on electrophile, so this is the electrophilic center. So the angle in which nucleophile is approaching towards the carbonyl carbon is fixed, which is discovered by this scientist Burgi-Dunitz, and that angle is known as Burgi-Dunitz angle. It is 107 degree. Okay, so the nucleophile is attacking as this is a smaller group, and this is either hydrogen or alkyl group, so there are minimum interactions between them. So our H minus here is a nucleophile. This H minus, or we can say simply nucleophile, NU nucleophile, can attack from this side. Okay, so this is a carbonyl carbon. If the nucleophile is attacking from this side, okay, and the angle between this attack of nucleophile and carbonyl group is 107 degree. This is Burgi-Dunitz angle. Now what happened here? We can write so when nucleophile is attacking on this side, we can write here nucleophile. Okay, so front carbon atom, then this OH will be converted to O, carbon oxygen double bond will be converted to OH, and this is R group. So these are the atoms or groups attached to the front carbon atom. This is carbonyl carbon atom. Nucleophile is attacking So hydroxy will this bond will revert like this, and this R group will be like this. Okay, and the rear carbon atom atoms and groups remain as it is. So this is L, this is S, and this is M. So the substance attached to the rear carbon atom will be remain as it is. Okay, now we can rotate this molecule, okay, in such a way that the R and larger group, okay, so the larger group and larger group on the front carbon atom and larger alkyl group on the front carbon atom and larger group on the rear carbon atom are the away from each other, because it is carbon carbon single bond is there, so we can rotate it by any angle. Okay, so R, so I am taking R here, so nucleophile will go here and hydroxy will here. Okay, and the atoms or substance attached to rear carbon atom I am keeping as it is L, then here S, near M. Smaller group, larger group, medium group on the rear carbon atom. So this is H or alkyl or aryl group on the carbon atom. This is incoming nucleophile and this is hydroxy. Okay. So these and these structure are same. Only the carbon-carbon single bond rotation is allowed. That's why I have written in like this. Okay. Now the second possibility is that when larger group is like this, larger group carbonyl R, and larger group is here, medium group will be here and smaller group will be here. Okay, now in this case I am, what is the change here? Larger group I have taken here from the left hand side. Okay, from the left hand side if I have taken, then accordingly the medium and smaller group are also changing their position. Now in this case the R group and this medium group on this say alpha carbon atom are near to each other, so that's why our nucleophile, that is H minus, experiencing some crowding, so that's why this attack is not favorable. Okay, so this is a favorable attack. So this is the stereochemistry of product found by the nucleophilic attack of this hydride on this chiral aldehyde molecule. Okay, now consider the example is like that. So aldehyde is there, so phenyl group, hydrogen atom is there, smaller, and this is methyl. So what will be the aldehyde in straight chain formula? So we can write here phenyl group, then this is methyl alpha carbon atom, hydrogen is below the plane, okay, and this is CO H. So this is the given aldehyde. Okay, front carbon atom carbonyl group, hydrogen opposite to that of carbonyl, this is alpha chiral center. Okay, and the larger group phenyl group I have written it in opposite perpendicular to this carbonyl group, then medium group methyl group is there, so I have written in this position, okay, and hydrogen in this position. Okay, so this is the stable conformation which I have drawn from this given structure molecule. Okay, given molecular structural conformation. Okay, now first of all this is your attempt, you should attempt like this, from the given structure you should write the stable conformation of the given carbonyl compound, and this is this one. Now we can attack here. We have to reduce this molecule by LiLH4. So reducing agent is LiAlH4. Now this is the stable conformation, and this is hydrogen, this is hydrogen, and our nucleophilic angle, nucleophilic attack angle is 107 degrees Celsius. So in nucleophile, or you may write H minus, okay, can attack in this angle, Bourguignon's angle 107 degree. So when it is attacking, carbon oxygen bond is breaking, and we are getting a situation like this, front carbon atom. So it is OH hydrogen here, and incoming nucleophile will be like this. The remaining rear carbon atoms substituents are keeping as it is, PH, PH and methyl group. Okay. Now what is the situation? Okay, so we can write, so this phenyl group and incoming nucleophile are anti to each other, opposite to each other. So we can write phenyl, then phenyl, then rear carbon atom having methyl above the plane. Methyl above the plane, then hydrogen below the plane, no need to write. Then the front carbon atom, that is carbonyl carbon atom, and this carbonyl carbon atom as having the hydroxy group above the plane. Then one hydrogen is below the plane, no need to write, or you can also write here, this is hydrogen of this carbon atom, alpha carbon atom, this is hydrogen of alpha carbon atom, this is hydrogen of carbonyl carbon atom, and this is nucleophile. Okay, so this is the structure. No need to write this hydrogen alpha here. So two carrier centers are there, this one and this one. Okay, so we are getting dash stereoselectivity here, and we are getting this product as a major product, this product as a major product. So that's why such reactions are known as dash stereoselective aldol asymmetric reactions, or aldol condensation dash stereoselectivity in reduction, let us say, not aldol, dash stereoselectivity in aldol in reduction reaction of carbonyl compounds. So this is the situation. Okay, now here we can write here nucleophile, instead of nucleophile we can write here hydrogen, because hydrogen is a nucleophile, H minus is the nucleophile. So this is the case. Okay, Now second example is like that. PH methyl group hydrogen carbon oxygen double bond here ethyl group. Okay, so this is the given carbonyl compound CH3CH2CO. This is chiral center, alpha carbon atom. Okay, and the substituents are hydrogen, methyl and phenyl. So this is larger, this is medium, and this is smaller group. Okay, so arrange this molecule in this case. Okay, so what is the difference here? What is the difference here? Instead of hydrogen here, we can write ethyl group. We can write ethyl group. Okay, again all the remaining things will be same. So hydrogen, that is H minus, will attack from this angle, and you will get, so nucleophile is again, I'm writing here hydrogen. Okay, and phenyl group, methyl group, hydrogen, and here it is ethyl group, here it is ethyl group, ethyl group will be taken place like this. Okay, now phenyl, now the case is phenyl, then rear carbon atom having methyl group above the plane, and hydrogen below the plane. Okay, stereochemistry is fixed here. Then front carbon atom, carbon carbon single bond, rear to front carbon carbon single bond, then hydroxy above the plane. Okay, and hydroxy above the plane, and here ethyl group, ethyl group is below the plane, so I am writing here ethyl group below the plane, and this hydrogen is in the plane, hydrogen is in the plane. So this phenyl group, this rear carbon atom, front carbon atom, and this hydrogen, they are in the plane of the molecule, they are in the plane of the molecule. Okay, phenyl group, rear carbon atom, front carbon atom, and this hydrogen, they are in the plane of the molecule. Okay, like this, 1 2 3 4. Now this is a general conceptualization, that or general acceptance, that while writing the structures in a straight chain formula or in wedge and dash formula, the alkyl groups have must be in a at the terminal ends of this zigzag or wedge and dash formula. So that's why, as this is a hydrogen, okay, in the plane, so this is a carbon carbon single bond, we can simply rotate this bond, and that's why our due to this bond rotation, our substituent's position will be changed, keeping this molecule, keeping this carbon carbon atom as it is, front carbon atom, rear carbon atom, pH CH methyl group. Okay, then I am rotating this, so that's why ethyl group will be coming here, ethyl group. Why it is ethyl? CH to CH, so long chain is there, so that's why. Now hydroxy will go down, that is below the plane, and this hydrogen will go above the plane. So what is the product here? LiAlH4. So such problems can be asked in your examination. So apply this is not a simple reduction of carbonyl compound, so this is a chiral reduction, this is a chiral ketone, so that's why you are reducing the chiral ketone with the help of LiAlH4, and that's why your product is like this, and you should write this molecule pH CH methyl group hydrogen, then this carbon, then this ethyl, okay, and the hydroxy group is alpha, hydroxy group is alpha. Okay, so this, we are getting this product exclusively, this product, so this is known as dash stereoselective reduction in carbonyl compounds using LiAlH4 or NaPH4. Another molecule is, another example is there, so this is the tertiary butyl group. Ethyl group, okay, then carbonyl methyl, okay. Then write the stable conformation of this molecule. So in this case, carbonyl is, this is carbonyl, this is methyl, this is methyl group, okay. Now tertiary butyl group is the larger group, then ethyl group is a medium group, and hydrogen atom at this alpha carbon is smaller group. Okay, so tertiary butyl group is, I am writing it as it is, tertiary butyl, okay, then middle group, medium group, ethyl group, sorry, medium group I can write here, and this is hydrogen. Okay, now the nucleophile, we have to reduce this with the help of NaBH4, sodium borohydride. So NaBH4 H minus is the nucleophile, it can attack through this, and we are getting OH methyl hydrogen. Okay, remaining groups as it is, tertiary butyl, here hydrogen, and here ethyl group. Now simply write the, so this tertiary butyl group on this alpha carbon atom and this methyl group on the front carbon atom must be opposite to each other. So rotate the molecule accordingly, and so that's why we are rotating the rear carbon atom. So that's why the atoms or groups attached to the front carbon atom are remaining as it is: methyl, hydroxy, okay, and this is tertiary butyl group. I am rotating the back carbon atom, so that's why this will be tertiary butyl, okay, and ethyl group will be here and hydrogen will be here, okay, and that's why I can write this conformation in simple wedge and dash formula or straight chain. So first carbon atom is tertiary butyl, then rear carbon atom where ethyl group is above the ethyl group is above the plane, yes, ethyl group is above the plane, hydrogen is below the plane, then front carbon atom where hydroxy is below, methyl is in the plane, okay, hydroxy group is below the plane. So this is the product that we are obtained when we are reducing this molecule with NaBH4, okay. So this is all about the general rule that we are applying with the help of Felkin and model to the carbonyl compounds, reduction of carbonyl compounds. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.